What's going on, family? I know it's been a minute since I made a video, and I know in the last couple of videos I said, if I remember correctly, in Italian and in Spanish that I would have a surprise for you all. Well, the surprise is going to be coming within the next couple of weeks or so, depending on my schedule and everything. But I can let y'all in on the surprise now for those who were actually interested. I just got back from a 10-day trip in Italy, and it was awesome. I experienced the countryside, the city, and the coastline, and when I tell you, it's an experience that I recommend everybody should do. It was, oh my God, it was ridiculous. But anyway, okay, I'm losing my train of thought. Let me get back on course here. What I'm going to be doing over the next couple of weeks or so is, because I don't want to post all the videos that I took at the same time. I didn't take a lot of videos. I took more pictures than anything. I was able to get some level up videos. That was a bit difficult in some areas because, some of the areas that we visited were, heavy with tourists, so it's kind of hard to record somebody and be incognito about it. But, had some rather pleasant and interesting and even a couple of disturbing experiences. So there I will be making videos in between posting the level up videos and things like that. I have a couple of videos that were just like blogs, video blogs that I was taking, video of just activities that were going on in the places that we were in, and some videos just me rambling or whatever. Just, a lot of this stuff I want to share with the people who subscribe to my channel, but also just to keep for my own memories, just so some of the stuff you might look at and be like, why the hell did he post this? Some of the videos, and I will try to put it in the description box, like, this is just for my own memory, things like that. But most of the videos, I'm rambling. One thing I can tell you is that I recommend the experience for anyone who is thinking of going to Italy or going to another country, period. Even after 2 years of studying Italian, I on a regular basis got my ass whipped and loved every second of it. I got beat down each and every time, and the people, I would have to say maybe 90% of the people, maybe even 95% of the people, the native Italians that we ran into, wonderful people, wonderful people. Of course, you got assholes wherever you go, but about 90% of the people, especially the people when I tried to talk to them, because there were many people who didn't speak a lick of English. So they didn't speak a lick of English. I went with my girlfriend. She doesn't speak Italian. So depending on what we were looking for, what we were trying to do, I had to pull my pants up, dust myself off and get in the ring with them, 12 rounds. And I got my ass handed to me multiple times, but everything we wanted to do, we got accomplished. Even with my, I would say now, I'm at a very, very low intermediate level in my Italian after going there and dealing with people who spoke no English and being able to work my way around certain situations and things like that. Someone might say it's lower, some might say it's higher. I don't know. I'm thinking it's lower intermediate level. I can't really talk about everything, and then when you're in the moment, you don't have a book in your hand or an audio playing in your ear. Words leave you and words come back, and you'd be like, oh my God, I should have said this when I was talking to that person. Had many of those moments, and then there were a couple of moments where the words just flowed. If I got stuck, it was because it was a word I just didn't know. I didn't have the vocabulary, but most of the people, include especially the people that I have video of, were very patient. They spoke very slowly, although like my girl would say, it didn't sound like it, but they were talking at snail's pace to make sure that I understood. So I am greatly appreciative of those people who would who were just like, it was, I guess it was a thing of, they asked the usual question, how did you learn? Where did you learn? Why are you learning? And once I answered all of those questions, they had no problem sitting there if I needed to pause or if I'm staring at the ceiling, like, oh my God, I don't know this word. No one got impatient, no one fussed. They were happy just to hear me talk, a Black American. And unfortunately, there will be a video about race coming up. A couple of topics I want to touch on. I won't get too much on the soapbox, but after having this experience, there are certain things that I would like to pose to the community and see what the responses will be. But yeah, it was awesome. 10 days in Italy. There were 4 days in Greve and Chianti, which is about 30 kilometers south of Florence. Didn't get to go to Florence, but went to Siena. Siena was interesting. Went to Rome. Wine tour in the Umbria region. And traveled around the Amalfi Coast. Nocelle, Positano, Amalfi, Ravello, the island of Capri. All of it. Gorgeous. But you'll see in the videos. But that was the surprise. That was my first international trip, period. I've never been to Canada, Mexico, Caribbean, so outside of US borders, that was my first trip. Wanted to do it big. I can't wait to do it again. Like I say, it was awesome. And still trying to decide when's the next, where, not when, but where is the next trip gonna be? Because I think I want to tackle, I think I'm ready to start tackling French. French has been stuck in my craw for, 17 years now, I can say, since I took class in high school and forgot everything the day I graduated. That's been one language that I've been wanting to conquer. So French is definitely coming up. Won't be going to France no time soon because that's a pretty difficult language for me, at least for me. Maybe easy for others, but I want to be, now that I know how it is to be in the country and deal with people who just speak no English, I kind of know at least where I want to be. I mean, if I'm not at a certain level, it's not going to stop me from going. I will go with some French, but, and same Spanish and everything else, but I want to at least hand out some beat downs while I'm getting beat down. Feel what I'm saying? But yeah, so I'm gonna post I'm gonna probably post the first level up video. And please, these videos are, I don't have the equipment to put subtitles and everything on there, so I'm sorry about that. They are not extremely long. Like, I don't have the language capacity yet to go for hours at a time. Like my buddy Lao Shu, he's the master, he's the man. Hats off to him. I'm getting there. Getting there. But not there yet. So these videos are pretty short, 10 minutes or less, but just to show that, just like Lao Shu Moses says, get out and speak to natives. And I didn't speak to too many natives while I was here, and I still went to the country. And even if I wanted to only speak English, there were situations where that was just not possible. I'm sorry. It just, we found ourselves in not many situations. I mean, you, depending on where you're going, you run the risk of, let's say you go into an establishment because you need to buy something that's important, medicine or whatever. And if those people don't speak any English and you don't speak their language, or like in my case, Italian, you don't speak any Italian, you're at an impasse. You have to basically just leave. So it's, unless you go to places, unless you go to a country saying to yourself, I am only gonna stay in the tourist traps. I'm not gonna go anywhere where the real people are. I'm just gonna stay in the tourist traps where I know I can find a lot of English speakers and other Americans. And because we ran into people who did that. And yeah, that's the safe way to go, but oh, the experience is just so much more fulfilling when you talk to the natives and you show them that you appreciate their language and they feel your appreciation and they show you Their appreciation of your efforts to not only learn but communicate and show respect for their culture and their language. I mean, it could be anything from 3 to 4 star service being bumped up to 5 star service just because there's a rapport or camaraderie that is built just from saying a couple of words, or going out to dinner and the owner, sending your table free drinks, or buying something in an establishment, and you might get a little small trinket for free. And then again, it's not, I'm not saying do this, for monetary gain or things like that, but it's like that, it's the way that some of these people, say thank you. That's their way of saying it's like, thank you for respecting my culture. Just for the people who are here in the US, just think about it. How disrespectful would it be for a Russian to come up to you in your city in the United States and say, in the only words that he knows in English are, do you speak Russian? Now, most people's reaction would be like, hell no, I don't speak Russian. This is the US. We speak English. You need to speak English when you come here. Well, they feel the same way. So to actually speak with them and not only speak and just know survival phrases, but I think with my experience, the fact that even though I was struggling, I lost my train of thought a lot of times. I lost my words a lot of times, but I did my best to, once I engaged them in Italian, I tried my best to keep it in Italian. And some of the people had such broken English that they were relieved, as scared as I was to speak Italian to them, they were more relieved that they didn't have to communicate with me, a foreigner, in English. They were like, oh God, okay, he knows a little bit of Italian. We'll work with his broken Italian than having him work with my broken English. That was a relief for them, and they were like, thank you for trying, and you speak so what they are very complimentary, even though there were a couple of times my Italian was straight garbage, or at least, I mean, better than person who's never studied. We always say that you're ahead of the person who never starts, but you always want to be better. And I know I'm rambling right now, so I'm gonna go ahead and end this. But yes, over the next couple of weeks, because I want to span it out, open up a dialogue, make sure I get all my thoughts together as far as, because I just got back a couple of days ago, so I'm still like on their time zone, jet lagged, tired. I had to go to work the very next day, but I do not regret it whatsoever. So yeah, that is the surprise that I had for you all. Went to Italy for 10 days. Had a layover in Amsterdam. After the Amsterdam is gorgeous. I don't know Dutch, so no level ups, and it was 50 degrees and rainy, so no video. I just got a few pictures. Gonna have to go back there when it's warm because September 50s, no good. Not for me. Sorry. So I saw a little bit of it, but that was basically about it. Just a little bit of a layover, and then it was back home to make the donuts. So, family, it's nice being back. Kind of bittersweet because I wish I was still in Italy, but I want to share my experience with you just to show that, people will embrace you. And we're all in this community looking to learn another language, expand our horizons, expand our world. Your world gets bigger and smaller at the same time because it's like now you can communicate with these people and everything like that, and people appreciate it. So next couple of weeks I'm going to be sharing my experience. Hope you like it. And hopefully it inspires somebody to, step out and take a chance on their own to, get in the ring for a 12 rounder and throw a couple of haymakers in and catch quite a few of them like I did. So, I'll be talking to y'all later. Thanks again for the support. Peace.